You don't need us to tell you that 2020 was horny as heck. We spent months without human contact, and even when we did venture outside, kissing might as well have been illegal, and TV did not help. Without our usual physical relationships, including sex, kissing, hugging, or even just a handshake at this point, every minor physical touch on TV became unimaginably erotic. Was TV horny this year, or were we? Instead of an answer, let's do a list. Here are the top horniest moments of TV in 2020. Number 1. The gays, normal people. Normal people is essentially about two individuals who hook up on and off for the better part of a decade. They're not really dating, but they do have a lot of sex. The show required extra attention to the material, including an intimacy coordinator and poring over the pages of Sally Rooney's original novel, so it led to some actually really beautiful television sex scenes, unlike anything we've ever seen before. Daisy Edgar Jones and Paul Mescal have some truly remarkable chemistry. In one of the most memorable hookup scenes, they don't actually have sex. In fact, neither of the actors even really removes any clothing. Connell slides his hand underneath the covers to pleasure Marianne, and then we watch him watch her experiencing this touch. I can't, it's too much. Someone fan, can we get a fan? Thank you. Number 2, the barista scene and Love, Victor. Love, Victor's underrated teen romance had a lot of cute scenes between its characters, but the peak horniest moment was, of course, the barista training. Victor's love interest Benji teaches him how to make a cappuccino, but Victor's closeted brain transforms this into a slow-mo R&B sequence that is just oozing horniness. There's a pouring steamed milk. You get it. Number 3, the possibility of Camille on Emily in Paris. Emily in Paris is a very silly show about very silly people, none of them sillier than the small army of Frenchmen who practically trip over themselves to fall in love with Emily, who is basic as hell. But the horniest moment in the entire show is when Emily meets Camille. The sexual chemistry between these two women is out of control, and that's not even counting the fact that they accidentally kiss on the mouth in their first meeting.
Oh!
Anyway, then it's boring because she never really asks for the threesome that the show desperately needs, but maybe in season 2. I won't hold my breath. Number 4, Cake, Insecure. Insecure season 4 is primarily about deteriorating relationships, primarily Issa and Molly's friendship, but also including Molly and Andrew in their relationship. Episode 2 catches up with Molly and Andrew in the early honeymoon phase of their relationship, when they still had time for date night and were constantly undressing each other with their eyes. At one point, Andrew's getting stressed about something else, and then Molly's like, "Hey, what's up?" And he says,
"I'd rather talk about that cake I'm gonna have later."
And then Molly says,
"I'm not sharing."
And then, take the cake! To an ass slap I can still hear through space and time. He got that cake. He got it good. Number 5, the fantasy of Paxton on Never Have I Ever. Okay, remember when I mentioned porn earlier? Mindy Kaling's Never Have I Ever wore its horniness from its sleeve in the very first episode. There's nothing new about horny teens, but Devi was groundbreaking in that she was the first openly horny South Asian teen in mainstream television. Every time we see Paxton in the early episodes of the show, it's through Davy's horned up eyes. If you feel weird crushing on a teen like this, don't worry, he's 29. Episode 2 opens with Davy having a dream about Paxton, who has also agreed to have sex with her, no strings attached. He appears in her bedroom, whips off his shirt in one criminally smooth motion, and then says all these sexy things to her like,
"Wow, your body looks so good in that oversized t-shirt."
We don't know what 2021 will bring, but horny TV is probably here to stay. You didn't hear it from me, but Bridgerton is now streaming on Netflix.